today we're backstage with all the stars at the British National Movie Awards at the Royal Festival Hall. Vivienne Westwood launches her new Red Label 2009 Spring Collection at London Fashion Week. Busy week for the young royals. Princess Beatrice turned 20. Prince Harry celebrated his 24th birthday, and a surprise announcement, Prince William extends his term with the Royal Air Force. Sir Paul McCartney receives the top honour at the MTV Europe Music Awards in his hometown of Liverpool. And welcome to Hello Today, the heart of Hello TV, and welcome to the very first week of our brand new channel. I'm Gaby Roslin, and I'll be here every day live in the Hello Today studios to bring you all the latest news. We'll be covering awards, events, fashion, movies, music, TV, and daily updates on what your favourite celebrities are doing. Join me every day, and you'll never again be out of touch. We'll have exclusive interviews, we'll be taking you backstage to all the great events, and we'll be telling you all about the other fantastic shows here on Hello TV. Please email us your thoughts via our website and tell us all your news. Now, later in the show, I'll tell you all about our brand new Hello TV Awards, where your votes will decide the winners. But now today, Hello Today. We have such a great show for you. We have Keira Knightley, we have Paul McCartney, we have an exclusive interview with Channel 4's hot new property guru, and the world premiere of the new Medieval Babe single, and they're going to be singing live here at the end of the show. And there's even more. The top fashion designers tell Hello Today the secrets of their success. That's all coming up on Hello Today. Now, what a week it's been. Firstly, the National Movie Awards. What a turnout. These awards were only launched in the UK last year. And this year, London's Festival Hall was filled to the rafters with all the top stars, including a surprise appearance by Nicole Kidman. Now, top prize winners included Daniel Craig for Bond, of course, and the wonderful Meryl Streep for Mamma Mia.
Thank you very much. Too, man. I'm so happy. This is the greatest award because it sort of throws it in the teeth of the critics.
The original punk visionary Vivienne Westwood launched her new Red Label collection for 2009 at London Fashion Week.
Red Label is a commercial collection. It helps an enormous lot to make you look very feminine. It just fits and it's really, really great.
Loving those sparkly dresses. Now, the royal family have been busy too this week. While Princess Beatrice celebrated her 20th birthday with a night out on the town, her cousin Prince Harry celebrated his 24th birthday by supporting one of his favourite veteran charities. And Prince William surprised everyone by his announcement that he'll be extending his service in the Royal Air Force for a further term. For the next 5 years, he'll be busy serving his country, and of course, everybody here wishes him the very best of luck. Now, while the young princes were busy in the UK, Prince Charles and the Duchess of Cornwall paid an historic visit to Japan and were welcomed by His Imperial Majesty Akihito, the 125th Emperor of Japan, and his wife, the Empress Michiko. Sir Paul McCartney collected a Lifetime Achievement Award last night in his hometown of Liverpool. Surrounded by his friends and family, he received a rapturous reception at the MTV Europe Awards.
Right. There is one person in this hall tonight whose work is immortal. There is only one Paul McCartney. I want to thank my mates, Ringo, George and John. Many years ago, four little boys
born here in Liverpool. And we went on to do quite well.
If I think, you know, back to my mum and dad and being raised here as a kid, you know, listening to the radio, and if you told me, you know, I'd be here doing this and getting this, I couldn't believe you, obviously.
Hey, it was fantastic. Set up. Brilliant, man.
Good for your hometown as well to be here.
Yeah, love it, love it. Always love being here. Fantastic. Best place, centre of the universe, you know what I'm saying?
I want to thank my mum and dad. Jim and Mary. I want to thank my brother Mike, who's here tonight, and everyone in my family. A fantastic family here in Liverpool.
Now, we all love television shows about interior design and beautiful houses. And Hello Today is delighted to have as our guest here in the studio the star presenter of the latest Channel 4 series, The Home Show, award-winning architect Angela Brady. Angela, you are definitely the glamorous side of architecture and architects and homes. Look at you.
Well, that's very kind.
No, but you always look fabulous on the show as well.
Well, it's fun. It really is a fun show, and it's all about really what's happening today in architecture and interior design. And what I love about it is I get the glamorous piece of going all around the world seeking out design secrets from, you know, Venice and Copenhagen and all these beautiful cities.
Where do you get your inspirations from? Because, of course, you've been an architect now for many, many years.
Yes.
You're an examiner. The list of your credits is incredible for you. But where do you get your inspiration from?
I used to live in Copenhagen, so I love Scandinavian design. And it's so, you know, cool, clean and modern. You know, I do like IKEA. And I think...
Good, so it's nice to hear somebody actually say that for once.
Yeah, I mean, I think they bring fantastic modern contemporary design to the masses. It's cheap and cheerful. And I think, you know, it's well designed and well made. And I think that, you know, people aren't really moving anymore. They're going to stay really in their homes where they are because they can't afford to move. And I think that once people really relook at their homes with kind of fresh eyes, it can still be fun and exciting, and you can clear out all that clutter and really make your home a home.
So that's the most important thing, to clear out clutter, do you think?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Too many people have too much junk in their houses.
But also, interestingly, in a clip we're about to see, there's something else that you think we should get rid of, which I want to talk to you about. Let's have a look.
Okay.
Let's have a look.
Unlike Britain, the main living room in a finca tends to be on the first floor, raised above the bustle of the farm life downstairs.
One of the beautiful things about the first floor is you get the view all over your farmland, and here it stretches for quite a way. And what we have here is the wonderful Majorcan window. I love this system because I personally hate curtains. They never block out the light. They're constantly all over the place. They block the heat. But with a system like this, it's just so simple, so practical. And I say, bring it back.
No curtains.
I hate curtains.
No, I'm really confused because I've just painted my sitting room because we can't afford to do any differences. So we just painted it. And we had the sofas recovered, okay? So
yeah,
instead of buying new ones.
Mm-hmm.
But I need my curtains. I've got no curtains on the windows, and David, my partner, doesn't want curtains. What's that about?
Well, you know, I really hate curtains. I think they're so old-fashioned and they're so impractical, and for all the reasons that you've just seen in that clip, I think there are so many other ways of, you know, of cutting out the light from a window and just showing off more of your wall space.
But what if you've just got a plain white wall?
Put lots of pictures on it, you know, really kind of bring in your own personality and character to your walls.
Okay. Now, the other thing I'd like to talk to you about is women in architecture.
Yeah.
It is not usual. You usually think of women, if you don't mind me saying, as interior designers, not as interior architects. So how can you change everybody's view of that?
I'm a very staunch supporter of women in architecture, and you know, one of the big things that we did really was to try and change people's perception that women and men together can do architecture equally well.
And it's not just the fluffy cushions,
not
is it?
Not at all. I hate fluffy cushions.
Funny you should say that. I thought not. So you like this? This is okay.
This is rather
for you.
Nice, yes. But it could actually do with a bit more support in the back.
Oh, she's just, you're never happy. Angela, it's been so lovely. Thank you very, very much indeed.
Lovely to meet
Thank
you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, do you ever wonder where the top fashion designers get their ideas from? Well, wonder no more. Hello Today brings you backstage to hear from the designers themselves. They tell us exactly what or who inspired their 2009 spring collections and what we're all going to be buying on the high streets next year.
The inspiration's taken from a book called Leaves in a Missionary's Tale. It's a rather saucy story about a missionary woman who goes to the tropics and falls foul of religion.
You are living in New York, and you live in New York, and you sometimes forget you have a beautiful park. This collection is inspired by Central Park, and in terms of beautiful afternoon, outdoors, something really, really fresh, beautiful girly dresses, that is my collection is about.
The seduction is the most important part of my collection.
It's a tribute to Charlie's Angels, so it's a 70s kind of woman. She's very chic, she's very, the waistline's come back, the pants are slightly flared. A little bit getting into a little disco. Bit disco for night.
Inspiration for this season, I started from a new kind of superhero, a modern hero. A girl, very strong, very conscious, that I like to found always something new.
At the end of the day, I wanted to do a collection that celebrated women and femininity. The new colour is a powder colour, it's a lipstick colour, it's colours of makeup or foundation, light blues, flesh tones and chocolate browns.
The meaning is a celebration of the beauty of the women, of the shape of the body. Fashion and trends matched with the respect of the body.
We always wanted to do a clothing line, just timing and all that, especially with this career.
I think we feel the medium is right and it won't be misunderstood.
I think music influences fashion.
I like the evening to be with the movement in this, in the dresses, because the materials are very soft. The chiffons and organza. It's like the Botticelli paintings, that they have that movement.
I travel very much. I meet a lot of interesting people, artists. I get a lot of inspiration from art and music.
I like this hairdo, I took it as inspiration because in fact it was Brigitte Bardot's hairdo from the late 50s and 60s. She used to invent that, it was a French called the choucroute, and she made it with her dark hair. Because for me it's a double clin d'œil, it's Brigitte Bardot and Amy Winehouse.
My goodness, Karl Lagerfeld inspired by Amy Winehouse, who would have thought it? Now, here on Hello TV, we love fashion and that we know that you do too. So this fabulous new channel will be bringing you not one, but two fashion shows. Who, What, Where on Mondays at 10 will be exploring what you wear and how clever you are at creating your very own unique look. Hello TV's haute couture show called Hello Fashion will cover the great shows from all around the world. We'll be bringing you exclusive access to everything fashion, so don't miss tomorrow's Hello Fashion at 5 o'clock, which includes an exclusive interview with the great Valentino.
And a woman, she must be feminine, glamorous, sexy, nice looking, because a woman, she loves compliments. She loves to be always the center of attention.
Very sensual, but very chic.
Jaw-droppingly beautiful.
I remember very well when I was young. My mother used to say, you are a dreamer. You always dream about stupid things.
I try to do my best. I try to do the clothes that I love. And people, they are there. If they like it, okay. If they don't like it, I can.
Those gorgeous pugs, the must-have Valentino fashion accessory, obviously, of the season. Now, don't miss Hello Fashion tomorrow night right here on Hello TV at 5 o'clock. Now, we're going to take a short break, but don't even think of going anywhere, because coming up in part two, we have Keira Knightley talking about her latest role in The Duchess, and I'll be telling you all about the exciting new Hello TV Awards. And we have live music, a world premiere, no less. So we'll see you in a moment.
Now from London, Rimmel's new full-volume lipstick. Pump it up for lips that look fuller, bigger, and larger than life. See it to believe it. Big is beautiful. New full-length lipstick from Rimmel London.
Welcome back to Hello Today. Now, there's still loads more to come, including live music right here in the studio. But first, let's talk about Keira. Since she first burst onto our screens in films like Bend It Like Beckham, Keira Knightley has gone on to make hugely successful films, acting opposite some of the world's most talented and, if I may say, handsome actors. Her most recent role in The Duchess has received rave reviews, and through her work on this film, Keira had many things. A fantastic leading man in Ralph Fiennes, a deep respect for the extraordinary heroine of the film, the original Duchess of Devonshire, some incredible frocks to wear, and a very sore neck.
It is His Grace's duty to produce an heir.
Certain obligations come with marriage, no matter how burdensome they may seem.
She was an incredibly huge fashion icon, a sort of a celebrity, I suppose, of that day and age. Hugely politically influential.
How's the campaign going?
Terribly.
Perhaps we could use my ability to draw attention to our advantage.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. Charles Grey.
Change is upon us!
You will give up your politics and settle down to the task at hand, providing the Duke with a son.
I ask but two things when we wed, loyalty and a male heir.
I made a conscious decision. I said to Saul, we've got to try and spin the scenes away from the obvious choice. So even though he is doing some pretty hard-line things, I think it's come from a place of this is what he believes is right.
You may go.
And I think on the page, it would have been very easy to make him into a villain, you know. And I think what's amazing about Ralph, and just shows what a fabulous talent he is that he manages to make him sympathetic at the same time, and I thought that was extraordinary.
For the life of me, I could never understand why women's clothes must be so damn complicated.
He's such a wonderful actor. I mean, he really is. It was amazing to get to work with him.
Hello again.
Hello. Your girls are lovely.
Thank you. Do you have any children?
I do. Three boys.
Three boys. What the Duke couldn't give for one of them.
It's always interesting to sort of, you know, delve into a period of time and see how strange the society was, how different it was, but also the similarities.
I saw you talking with my husband.
Yes. He wanted to dance.
It was very important that the costumes were right, and that, you know, I think that it's, when you're playing a part, it's important to understand what they wear and why they choose it. And she not only, you know, she was wearing them, but she was designing them all herself as well, and she was a huge fashion icon. They were literally made out of metal frames. So you have this metal frame that looks a bit like a birdcage on top of your head, but covered in hair. And they were so heavy, I couldn't hold my head up. So really nice guys built me like a wooden stand to prop the hair up so that, you know, I could rest it between takes. But it was, I mean, the tallest one was about 2 feet, and then I had 2 feet of feathers on top of that.
Well, there are only two specimens of this rare bird known to man. One of them has clearly ended up on top of my head. And the other, rumour has it, is running for office in the Tory party.
Sitting in cars was really hard, and there was a day when me and Hayley had like these huge hats on as well. We're literally in the back of a bus, kind of like that, because there was just no way of... So I don't know how they managed with carriages. I think they sat on the floor or something. It was extraordinary.
This will be the mistake of your life.
Trust me, that film is well worth going to see. Now, in part one of the show, you saw a sneak preview of Hello TV's new fashion show. Don't forget, it's on Tuesdays at 5 o'clock. And now I can tell you all about Hello Premiere. This is our weekly movie show with lots of exclusives you simply won't see anywhere else. The stars will invite us onto the set to see the action close up, and we've even persuaded some of them to take along a little Hello TV camera to record their video diaries just for you. Hello Premiere will of course have front row seats at all the premieres, and I do mean all of them, everywhere throughout the world. We'll bring you all the great movie stories and all the great movie stars. I can't wait. Hello Premiere will be on Hello TV on Wednesdays at 5 o'clock, and here's a sneak peek.
He has a way of raising his kids that he wants to happen, and when this couple moves in next door, they threaten this whole thing that he wants his kids to see and be influenced by.
But that's where I work. This is where I live.
You like carrying a gun?
There's nothing wrong with a little shooting as long as the right people get shot.
It's kind of like a thriller, so that genre of film I thought would be interesting to do with the director, John Avnet, and that's how it started.
Who left the fridge open?
Oh, the big screen. I'm a little fat film star.
Got a very sensitive gag reflex.
I'm a dude playing a dude disguised as another dude.
I guess it would be Ben.
Probably me or Jack.
Jack Black.
Jack.
You think you can do what I do? So when you near me, darling,
can't you hear me? SOS. I think of this character as the younger sister of the woman in Michael Clayton.
You kidding? Pull around the corner, we'll do it in the back.
You're so coarse.
Now, we all see celebrities on our screens and at glittering events, but many big stars donate a huge amount of time to helping those in need around the world. At Hello TV, we've been so inspired by their commitment that we've decided to launch the Hello TV Awards. These awards will honour those people, famous and unknown, who try to make the world a better place. Very simply, this is how these awards will work. We're asking you to nominate two people. Firstly, the celebrity that you think has made a real difference in the world. And secondly, we're asking you to nominate your own unsung hero, someone who you believe deserves recognition. And alongside your nominations, we've also asked the celebrities to put forward their unsung heroes. Any more information that you need, you can always visit our website. Now, one of the important roles celebrities take on is as a United Nations Goodwill Ambassador. They give their time to build up awareness, raise funds, and to do whatever they can to alleviate suffering. Goodwill Ambassadors Matt Damon and Wyclef Jean recently rushed to the help of the victims of the hurricane in Haiti. And just this week, Angelina Jolie was working with the refugees in Afghanistan.
Just trying to tell people what it was that we saw, which I still can't quite believe. I've seen extreme poverty before, but I've never seen it coupled with a natural disaster.
These families have been displaced for nearly 30 years. And now many returnees are facing reintegration difficulties. When you ask them what they need, they just smile and say, everything. When you ask them what kind of work they want to do, they say, anything. They have suffered so much. And yet, the Afghan people remain gracious and open. They have a quiet dignity.
There is so much to do, and all the ambassadors do a fantastic job. Please check out our website to learn more about how you could get involved in supporting these very worthwhile causes. And please don't forget to send in your nominations for your favourite celebrity who's made a difference and your unsung hero. Now, the Medieval Babes fantastic story began in 1996 when a group of friends broke into a North London cemetery and sang together, clad in flowing white gowns and crowns of ivy. Well, we'll find out what prompted that little bit of madness in just a moment. Since then, the Fair Maidens have had three hit albums in the classical charts. They have won an Ivor Novello Award and toured all over the world in venues from festivals to cathedrals, castles to caves, to nightclubs and Renaissance fairs. The new album is released next month. The single is out today. The world premiere performance will take place right here in the Hello Today studio. And I'm thrilled to introduce the Medieval Babes. What on earth were you doing, if you don't mind me saying? Putting on white gowns and jumping into a North London cemetery and singing?
Well, it all started, yeah, quite a long time ago when I went to Berlin and I met this woman called Dorothy Carter I was playing in a band with, and she played all these medieval cranky old instruments such as hurdy-gurdies and zithers and dulcimers, and she kind of inspired me to come back to London and convince all my friends that what we really needed to be doing with our lives was dressing up as princesses and singing medieval music. And I think I must have been, you know, incredibly persuasive, because I swept everyone up in this tide of conviction, and next thing you knew, we were breaking into cemeteries and singing in witches' circles in storms up in Hampstead Heath.
It does sound like some crazy Hammer House 1970s horror film.
I know, that's exactly what I was going for.
Oh, were you? Oh, I was right then. Now, 12 years later, you're all looking very innocent in your white gowns. Maybe not as innocent, though, looking at some of you. But, Emily, this time you're actually releasing a single, the first time you've ever done this.
It is. It's the first time we've ever made a single, and it's actually our sixth album. So this is, it's a very unique and new thing for us, you know.
But why now?
I think we just decided we wanted to try and do things differently this time. We've made an album that we feel is a little bit more accessible, you know. So we thought, why not have a single? So we've made a fantastic video as well.
Which I've seen, and it is wonderful. Now, Rabbit, I don't want to go to the music. I want to talk about this electrical stuff, because I remember hearing about you before meeting you and saying, oh, you know, it's going to be really dangerous. Rabbit in the studio, because everything electrical goes when she's around. Is that true?
My fame precedes me.
Not just objects.
I do tend to break computers or other electrical implements by being around them. I'm not sure why. Maybe just because I'm clumsy.
Oh, was that the only reason? I thought it was some wonderful sort of witchcraft that you were doing.
It could be, I suppose.
She keeps throwing them against walls.
That's probably what it is.
just don't let her near your laptop. And it's dead.
OK, you're not using my computer even though you beg. Essa, you're the newest recruit, aren't you?
That's right, yeah.
So what's it like for you to be part of the Medieval Babes?
It's fantastic. I mean, I first heard of the band years ago when I was at university, which was in about 1997. So years on, it's just fantastic to become a part of the band, because I really loved the music before that happened.
Now, the interesting thing, though, is that music has everything. Everybody seems to embrace all sorts of music now. We've got, you know, Teatro, who do stuff from all the musicals. We've got, you know, Il Divo. You've got Amy Winehouse, everybody in between. And isn't it wonderful, though, that everybody seems to accept all types of music? Pom, don't you think times are changing with all of that?
Well, yeah. And when I wrote Miracle, it was a blend of, it was an experiment. I blended medieval elements and modern pop music elements and mixed them up in a salad bowl, and it worked really well.
OK, well, I can't wait to hear this. Bev, are you looking forward to doing this?
Absolutely, of course.
You're really going to sing this for me?
Yeah.
Fabulous. Well, for a moment, until we see you sing live, Medieval Babes, thank you very much for being here.
Thank you.
You were looking so innocent, it's slightly frightening. The lovely babes are going to perform in just a minute. But before they do, let me tell you what's happening on Hello Today tomorrow. The incredible Cirque du Soleil come to town with their new show. We'll have an exclusive preview. Carla Bruni, the First Lady of France, talks to Hello Today about her new album and her favourite French designers. We go backstage at the new Dolce & Gabbana catwalk show and chat with the terrible twosome. The stars of the latest Bollywood extravaganza will be here on the sofa to tell us about their new show. And a real exclusive, Amy Winehouse will be here to perform an acoustic number from her new album. So I'll see you tomorrow, same time, same place. Until then, I leave you with the Medieval Babes.